Chiltern's favourite son, Barrie Cassidy, today returned to his hometown to launch its birthday celebrations. The event in January will celebrate 150 years since gold was discovered.
Barrie Cassidy today returned to the place where he grew up, and ahead of the town's 150th celebration says it's important to keep your heritage alive.
When you get a landmark like that, and if you celebrate it, everybody focuses on it and they start thinking about their heritage and their town. And if you don't, if you let these things go, then you're letting the history go.
Chiltern Primary School kids dressed in period costume joined in the launch. Cassidy says Chiltern should be recognised as a key part of Victoria's gold boom.
So that's the moment when Chiltern took off as a town, and at one stage at its peak it had 13 pubs, which is a fair measure of how big the town was.
As a respected political correspondent and former press secretary to Bob Hawke, Cassidy today also spoke of the future of news journalism. He says developments in broadcast media continue apace.
The stark reality is that 10 to 15 years from now there may not be newspapers at all, and that means a lot of journalists are going to have to find new careers or new ways of working in journalism.
Indigo Shire Mayor Peter Graham says the Australia Day celebrations will become an important part of the town's history, and says special guests Brooke Hanson and Barrie Cassidy are a major coup.
Well, it's like winning Lotto. They're two people that are significantly known throughout Australia. They'll be great draw cards. One is talking about history, and he's got a bit of age on him, maybe like the guy that's talking to you now.
Nathan Motton, Wind News.